In this module, we're going to take a look at the practicalities of setting up our corner weight scales, and there is no rocket science involved in this step. However, there are a few intricacies that we do need to keep in mind in order to make sure we get the best possible results, as well as consistency when we are corner weighting our cars from one session to the next. Now, this step naturally flows on from our last step where we established and set up our flat patch. The two really go hand in hand together. So at this point, we've already got an area marked out on the ground and we know that that area is flat. It's important when we're marking out that area, taking into consideration the size of the scales, because we're trying to set up our area so that when the car is rolled onto the scales, that the wheels will be relatively close to the center of the scales. Now, we don't have to be millimeter perfect here. There's definitely some room for error, but we're not going to get the best results if we've got the wheel set up with the tire right on one edge of our corner weight scales. While the scales are relatively robust, they're obviously a precision piece of measuring equipment and they need to be treated with care. For this reason, most scales will come in a robust carry case, as we can see here. Our first step, of course, is to remove the scales out of the case. Now, there's not a lot of areas where we can go wrong when we are setting up our scales. Probably the most common, which can be time-consuming and frustrating, is simply getting the scales on the wrong corner of the car. As we can see here with our Intercomp scales, each scale is marked with the correct location or orientation as to where it's going to sit on the car. It's simply a matter of taking note of that orientation and placing it in the correct position on our flat patch. Before we place the scales down on our flat patch, it's always a good idea to turn the scales over and just visually inspect them for any debris. It only takes a small amount of debris, rubber buildup, or even small stones to cause our scales to sit unevenly on our flat patch and rock. This will cause point loading, which again can affect the accuracy and repeatability of our measurements. Once we've got our scales in location, it's also a good idea to check the surface of the scales for level. Now, we can do this with our digital camber gauge, or alternatively, we can use a simple bubble gauge such as a builder's level. If we've completed the last step with our flat patch set up correctly, then by default, our scales should be level, but it's always a good idea to check. And when we're doing this, we want to check in both orientations, front to back and side to side, to ensure that the scales are in fact level. If they aren't, we can use a non-compressible packer, such as our vinyl tiles that we talked about in our last module, to even the scales out and make sure that the weighing surface is in fact sitting perfectly level. In our case, the scales that we are using are the Intercomp SW650 wireless scales, so there's obviously no wires running between the individual scales and the hand controller or unit where we're going to be viewing our measurements. In the case of a wired scale setup, we are also going to need to connect the wires to that hand controller, again making sure that our orientation of the individual wires is running to the correct scale and the correct location on the controller. Once we've done this, we can then turn our scales on and we can turn on our controller. With our Intercomp system, we've got the option of using different setups. Essentially, it's displaying the same information. Ultimately, we do only have the scales measuring the four corner weights. However, the different setups will, by default, display different percentage data, which can be useful for a particular job. In our instance, we're going to choose option three, which is for road race. This is the one we'd be using if we're setting up a road race or circuit car. Ideally, when we've turned the scales on, we should see all four sitting at zero. However, in this case, we can see we've got one of our scales is turned off. This makes it quick and easy to highlight which of those scales has a problem, and we can address that, get everything up and running. If it turns out that we've got one of the scales that is not reading zero, such as the case here, we can use the zero function on the controller to zero either an individual scale or alternatively all four scales together. Before we roll the car onto the scales, we do though want to make sure that all four of those scales are reading zero. Well, I've mentioned a couple of times making sure that our scale orientation is correct, and it really is important. This is a great time to perform a simple sanity check by simply standing on each of the scale pads individually and making sure that your weight shows up in the corner that you're expecting on the controller. Just doing this simple task before getting the car onto the scales can save a lot of time and frustration when we actually start making adjustments to the car. Now that we've got to this point, we can actually get the car up onto the scales. Now, for the purposes of doing this, we're obviously going to need to remove those front scales temporarily, roll the car into position, place our scales back and then our ramps, and we can simply drive the car or push the car up onto the ramps, again making sure that the car is loaded as close to the center of the scales as possible. Before taking any measurements, we want to make sure that the steering wheel is centered, and we want to make sure that we've got the handbrake on so that there's no danger of the car rolling off the scales accidentally. Now we can take a look at our corner weight readings, and while every scale system will be slightly different, predominantly they're all doing the same thing. Here we can see each individual corner weight being displayed, and the Intercomp system automatically totals these and gives us an overall weight. In this case it's being displayed in kilograms, but if you prefer you can choose to display this in pounds. While of course we can use a calculator to quickly calculate aspects such as our left weight percentage or our cross weight percentage, the Intercomp system does this automatically for us. Using the four buttons around the outside of the controller, we can choose which weights we want to add together. If we want to display our left weight, we can do this by selecting the left front and the left rear wheel. We'll then add these together and display the total left weight as well as the percentage of the total weight. If we want to display the cross weight, we can click on the left front button to remove that, click on the right front button to add this in. We now have our total cross weight as well as this being displayed as a percentage. Again, there's nothing particularly tricky about setting up and configuring your scales, but following through the steps that I've just presented in this module will give you the best chance of success as we move into actually making your corner weight adjustments. That was just one of the lessons from our practical corner weighting course. If you want to learn how to optimize the handling and balance of your race car, then this course is going to be perfect for you. You'll learn how the corner weights affect the balance of your car and what equipment you'll need to be able to measure and make adjustments to them. You'll learn how to analyze the handling balance at the tracks so you know what's wrong and what changes need to be made. You'll then learn how to set up a flat patch to work from so that you can be confident that your corner weight measurements are accurate and repeatable. Finally, you'll learn a simple six-step process that you can apply to optimizing the corner weights on any car. This will ensure that you get the right results without overlooking any critical steps.
If you liked that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.